feel good right now, and I know you think of things I could never think about. It's hard to count it all joy, distracted by the noise, just trying to make sense of all your promises. Sometimes I gotta stop, remember that you're God.
Well, good evening to you all. This is Associate Pastor Joe Wood of Pleasant Hill Baptist Church coming to you tonight, giving you May 17th, 2020's podcast. I would like for you to go with me to Romans chapter 8, verse 28, a very familiar passage out of Romans, one that you've heard many times. And I would like for you just to go there, and I've entitled tonight's podcast, A Reminder from Romans. A Reminder from Romans. So go with me to Romans 8, 28 very quickly. The Word of God says, "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to His purpose." Let's go to the Lord in prayer once again. Father, we just thank You for the day. Lord, thank You for Your blessings, for Your mercy, Your grace. Lord, I thank You for all the things You've given us this day, Father. Lord, I pray now that You would bless the reading and the proclamation of Your Word. God, I pray that it would challenge us. It would, Lord, it would help us during this week. Lord, it'd help us during our struggling times. And Father, we would just be encouraged by Your Word. And more importantly, God, we'd be encouraged by You, Father. So bless us now, and we love You. And we praise You in Jesus' name. Amen. I would like to ask you a question. While growing up, were any of you like me and had a father to remind you, even in the bad times that you go through in your life, that something good was going to come out of that situation? You know, I remember back in seventh grade, a long, long time ago, back in seventh grade, I did not make the basketball team at East Wilkes Middle School. Now, this was the first time in my life that I hadn't made a team that I tried out for, and I was devastated. You know, all of my friends were on the team, and I thought my life was ruined. I was embarrassed and felt like that all my world was coming to an end. Now, remember, I was only in seventh grade, okay, and didn't realize in that moment that basketball was not going to be my life. You know, I remember in that situation, my dad looked at me and said, "Son," he asked me the question. He said, "Do you love God?" I said, "Well, certainly, yes, I do, Dad." And then he looked at me and gave me the exact words that I did not want to hear nor think could be possible. He said, "Son, I want to tell you something. Something good is going to come out of you not making the basketball team." Well, guess what? It did. I recall one thing that happened was that I got to spend a lot of time with my dad, and while enjoying God's creation in the woods hunting. So that was one positive that came out of my situation. You know, the Bible clearly tells us that God uses every situation for something good. Here in our passage of Scripture, we find the truths of these words. Now, I want to give you some background information here. Now, the beautiful picture we find in Romans is we find that the truth that God assures deliverance to those that love God. As preachers outline in Bible states, man needs to get right with God, for he is under the condemnation and wrath of God. And we find that in Romans 1, 28 through chapter 3, verse 20. Then we see that man needs a right relationship with God. He needs to be justified, and that is declared righteous by God. We see that in Romans 3, 21 through verses 5 through chapter 5, 21. Then we see that a man needs to be freed from the struggle of sin, for sin corrupts and leads to death. We see that in Romans 6, verses 1 through 23. And then finally, we see that man needs to be freed from the bondage of law, spiritual legalism, for the law enslaves, accuses, condemns, and strikes hopelessness within the heart. We see that in Romans chapter 7, verses 1 through 25. And then we get to Romans Romans 8, one of my favorite chapters in all of the Word of God. And we see in this wonderful chapter, we find that God assures believers that He will deliver them from the bondage and corruption of their struggles. So tonight, I would like for us to be reminded of a few things from Romans 8:28 that will help you in struggling times. First, we see the circumstances for the reminder. The Bible does not say some things here in Romans 8:28. It does not say a few things, but Paul tells us that God says He works together all things. So the circumstances that God is working in is all things. As a believer in Christ, there is nothing that God does not control. God controls all events of the world, but also the happenings that occur in a believer's life. All things includes the good and the bad things that go on in our lives. Praise be to God, He is working in all the things that we go through. Aren't you glad tonight that we serve a God that is involved in everything that we go through? You know, it seems like so many times that our friends want to go with us through just the good times. However, our God in heaven says, I want to go with you through all things. God says, when we're hurting, I'm working with you through it. God says, when you're on the mountaintop, He's saying, I'm working with you through that. Praise be to God that we know that God is with us through all things. But not only do we see the circumstances that God is working in all things, but secondly, we see the continual act in the reminder. He is working together. As one writer wrote, work together means to create and eliminate, place and replace, connect and group, interrelate and intermingle, shape and forge, press and stretch, move and operate, control and guide, arrange and influence. So that is what God is doing. He is working together. He is arranging. He is controlling. He is moving and operating, stretching forth, arranging and influencing all the things that you and I are going through. If you look at the tense work together, that is in the present tense. So what does this tell me? This is telling us that God is working continuously for you and I. This coincides with how the beginning of the verse that says God is working together in all things for you and me. So the promise here is that throughout the Word of God, we find time and time again that God constantly is with us. He is continuously working for us, and He never leaves us nor forsakes us. Oh, but thirdly, there's a third thing that we see here. Not only do we see the circumstances for the reminder, we see the continual act in the reminder, but thirdly, we see the conclusion of the reminder. Since God is always working on behalf of ourselves and in all things, He is working to make all things good. Praise be to God that everything God does is for our good. You say, Joe, do you really believe that something good comes out of every situation that I go through? I'm here to tell you tonight, absolutely. Even when someone tragically passes away, I do believe that something good comes out of it. Now listen, I know that's really hard to hear, but I've heard many times that people have come to know Christ through funerals that they have attended. However, we don't always see the good things that come through every situation for those that love God. Furthermore, our idea of something good and God's idea may be different. When we say that God works out of all things for good, it's not always what you think is good. However, it is always what God considers good. His will over ours. You know, I reminded and remember when I was dealing with God's calling upon my life, and He was convicting me of His calling in my life. I was not willing to surrender at first because I didn't want to. You know, while I was convicted over God's will, my family was going through one of the hardest times that they'd ever went through at the church my dad was pastored at. Some of you have heard this before, but due to time, I'm not going to tell you all the details. However, as things got worse at my dad's church, I really began to get closer to God. You know, I really began to start thinking that it was okay to become a pastor. It was okay to become a preacher, and that this was the will of God in my life. I'd already knew that, but I was not willing to surrender to it. You know, I will never forget my father telling me, you know, after I surrendered to God's will in my life, I'll never forget what he told me. He said, "Joe," he said, if that's what it took for you to surrender to God's calling upon your life, then I would have went through it all over again. He said, I'd have went through all the heartache. He said, I'd have went through all the trials and the tribulations of that time in my life for you to surrender to God's calling upon your life. You know, that showed me two things about my father. First, it showed me that he loved me with a great deep love. But more importantly, it showed me and revealed to me that he loved the Lord Jesus Christ more than he did man. Because to have the attitude only comes through a thirst for Jesus Christ. He took one of the worst situations in all of his life and he looked at the good. You know, I believe with all of my heart that we are seeing positive things come from this pandemic. You say, well, the news media tells me all things that are bad and I would love to hear some good news. Well, I wrote down four things that I see that I have seen come to my mind through this time. First, homes are being restored. You know, I've heard many parents tell me since we have been sitting at home, we have talked about things more than we ever have. We have communicated so much better and shared with one another the things that are going on in each other's life. God created the home not for division or separate lives, but to be united as one family together, achieving all they can for the glory of Christ. Well, but not only that, but churches are getting out of the pews and into the community via technology. One thing that I believe the church as a whole, and I'm not just stating Pleasant Hill, but I'm speaking about the whole church of Jesus Christ. They have got complacent and lazy. God has made us get out of our comfort zones and get into the community. The gospel is being presented more than it ever has before. We are reaching more people with the gospel of Jesus Christ than we ever have because we have had to change our ways given the circumstances. Of course, I miss all of my church family, but I have been so blessed by the amount of people that have been watching our services, plus other churches as well. Oh, but thirdly, not only do we see first that homes are being restored, churches are getting out of their comfort zone, but thirdly, people are getting saved all throughout the world because of this pandemic. There has been more people asking questions more now than ever. People are desiring for a hope and they are wanting a lasting peace, and that only comes through Jesus Christ. But then fourthly, Christians that once were running from the Lord have found now strength and have been convicted through this. Oh, just the other week, someone that I've been praying for a very long time came up to me and said, "Joe, I want you to know when everything goes back to normal, we can go back to church. I'm going back to church." He said, "Joe, you know, and as well as I do, I have been running long enough from the Lord Jesus Christ. And instead of running any longer and instead of playing golf on Sunday mornings and all throughout Sunday, I'm going back to church." This was a very great encouragement to me. And I guarantee you, this is not the only individual. This has happened to. Listen, God is getting our attention. And he is getting the attention of the world and letting us all know that he is still God and he is still on the throne. And I'm asking you tonight to look at the good that is coming out of this pandemic. People are getting saved. Homes are being restored. Churches are doing what the Great Commission has commanded us to do. And people that have fallen away are coming back to God. There is good that is coming from this pandemic. And then finally, fourthly, we see the condition of the reminder. The condition of the reminder, it says, to them that love God, to them who are called according to this purpose. If we look back at the original Greek translation, it would be written like this: "But we know that to those who love God, all things work together for good." Listen, God looks after the affairs of those that love him and desire to be a relationship with him. If a person will not put their faith and trust in Christ, then he won't be taken care of. Listen, God promises to take care of His children, but those that He don't, He gives them a choice. God is not a God that forces things upon us, but rather gives us a choice. The choice is the greatest choice that anyone can ever make and has lasting implications, that has lasting eternal implications. Listen to me today. The greatest choice that you will ever make is what you do with Jesus Christ. Do you know Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior? Listen, God will take care of you if you are one of His. But if you're not, He will allow things to go on in your life. I promise you, all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose. Isaiah 41 verse 10 says, "Fear not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with thy right hand of my righteousness." If you're struggling tonight, in conclusion, to see the good in your situation, that is the devil trying to weigh you down. Ask God in your prayer time, in your time that you're reading His Word, ask Him to reveal to you what He wants you to see through this time. I promise from the Word of God, if you love God, then He is going to see you through this. We can't get through this without Him. And always remember, something good is going to come out of it. I can promise you that. Be encouraged and reminded of the wonderful truths in Romans. May God bless you.